Live podcasting is a great way to build an authentic connection with your listeners, and now it's easier than ever to set up. In this video, we'll show you how to live stream your show easily and how you can repurpose that content into a high-quality podcast episode afterwards. Live podcasting is when you record a podcast episode live with a virtual audience, either over a platform that supports live streaming or on various social media channels like Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Should you do it? The short answer to this question is that it depends on the goal of your podcast. A live podcast can be better than a traditional podcast in many ways. It's a great way to reach new audiences and to interact in real time with your listeners. It's also a great way to generate hype for an upcoming launch or event, and it's fun for you as a creator to try something new. What you have to remember is that being live comes with its own limitations. There's no way to fix technical errors and noise problems in the moment, but if you use a platform like Riverside, then you can get the best of both worlds. Riverside will record your live stream, so any in-the-moment errors still can't be fixed, but with the ability to download locally recorded separate tracks, you're able to edit the episode in post-production before publishing it permanently. When you're preparing for your show to go live, preparation is key. First off, if you have a guest, make sure to schedule the event with them ahead of time. Using an online scheduler like Calendly makes this easy. Make sure to do your research ahead of time. Create an outline of anything that you'd like to discuss and key points that you'd like to hit. If you have a guest, the conversation is likely to take twists and turns, but this gives you something to refer back to keep the live stream on track. Now let's talk about equipment. To live podcasts, you want to make sure that you have a good mic because good audio quality can make or break a good podcast episode. Some budget-friendly options that we recommend are the Samsung Q2U and the Rode Pod mic. Headphones are another great thing to have. You don't need these, but it's great for you and your guests to wear headphones to monitor any audio levels and any noise issues, your mic positioning, just to ensure the best audio quality. It also helps with audio bleed, which is when your mic picks up the output of another mic. Besides a mic and headphones, you're going to need a camera. You can use the webcam inside of your computer, but if you want to ensure really high quality video, then you can attach an external camera like a DSLR or an external webcam, and you can also use your phone. If you have a newer phone, there are apps that you can download to turn your phone into an external webcam. If you want to learn about how to do this, you can read our blog post linked below called How to Use Your Phone as a Webcam. When you're ready to stream live, head over to Riverside FM. You can sign up for a free trial, or if you already have an account, log in. From your main dashboard, you're going to go to your studio settings. Here, you can set up any live streaming channels that you'd like to set up. For the purpose of this video, let's set up YouTube. You're going to need your stream URL and your stream key, so head over to your YouTube channel. And you're going to copy both of these and insert them into the Riverside dashboard. The settings save automatically, so now when you press record in the studio, you will automatically start streaming live on YouTube. And that goes for any of these other channels that you set up as well. If you need information about how to set up with each of the channels, we have support articles linked that walk you through each one. You can also send your audience a link to watch your recording process live on the Riverside platform. With this link, they can also call in live, which is great for Q&As. Riverside will record the episode the same way it would a normal podcast episode. That way you can download, edit, and publish it permanently afterwards. You can also use the tools that Riverside provides to repurpose your content. Our clips feature is a great way to take highlight-worthy moments from your show and repurpose them for social media to promote it. At the end of the day, as long as you're creating content, you're going to keep moving. Live podcasting is a great way to reach new audiences, and with a platform like Riverside, you can reach audiences on all of your different social media channels at the same time. You don't need to invest a lot of money in order to podcast live. As long as you come prepared and you're creating valuable content, then it's best to just take the plunge and hit record. Your audience will stick with you on your journey as you figure out what works best. Thanks for watching this video. Let us know what your favorite show that uses live streaming is in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media for more media tips and tricks.